than the total of the debit sides, we will arrive at the gross profit and vice versa. So for that, the third entry will be prepared, Kanpur branch trading account debit to Kanpur branch profit and loss account 10,800. So this is the difference between this one and this one, because this is the amount which was to be recorded in the credit side of trading account. This is the amount which was supposed to be recorded in the debit side of trading account. So this amount is in excess by rupees 10,800. Therefore, this is the journal entry for the gross profit in the books of the head office. Well, friends, so these are the journal entries which we need to record in the books of the head office. So this was all about the items, all about the transactions which were supposed to be recorded either in the debit side of trading account or in the credit side of trading account. Now there are few items which are to be recorded in the debit side of profit and loss account, and there are some items which need to be recorded in the credit side of profit and loss account. So again, the items which need to be recorded in the debit side of profit and loss account, so for those transactions, so again the journal entry would be Kanpur branch profit and loss account debit to Kanpur branch. So here, instead of writing the word trading account, we will write the word profit and loss account, because these are the transactions which pertains to the profit and loss account instead of the trading account. And students, you are quite familiar that as far as the trading account is concerned, the items which pertains to the goods are recorded either in the debit side or in the credit side. But as far as the debit and credit side of profit and loss account is concerned, so in the debit side of profit and loss account, the indirect expenses and losses need to be recorded, and in the credit side, revenues and gains need to be recorded. So this is, you know, how the transactions are recorded. And then the transactions which need to be recorded in the credit side, the reverse journal entry will be prepared. So now we have the assets and liabilities. So as far as the assets are concerned, so for the assets, very simple, all the assets have a debit balance, so therefore the assets, individual assets, will be debited. Closing stock, it is given in the adjustment 9200. Furniture 4800 is given in the trial balance. Debtors 11200 is given in the trial balance. Branch cash is given 3600. So total of these four items is 28200. Let's check it. So yes, furniture 4800, debtors 11200, cash in hand 3600. And closing stock 9200, which is given in the adjustment. Then the journal entries for the liabilities. So this amount of rupees 400 as a creditor is also given in the trial balance credit side. We can check it in the credit side of sundry creditors. Yes, 400. So for this amount of rupees 400, the entry will be just a reverse. You can see Kanpur branch account debit to branch creditors. So in this journal entries for the asset, the Kanpur branch account was credited, but now we will debit the Kanpur branch, because this journal entry belongs to the liabilities, whereas this journal entry belongs to the asset. So for the assets, assets have always debit balance, therefore all the individual assets are debited and Kanpur branch account has been credited. Likewise, the liabilities have a credit balance, so therefore liabilities have been credited, and accordingly branch accounts has been debited by rupees 400. So now we can make the journal entries. Kanpur branch, so balance, it is given in the trial balance 22,000, and trading account, it is 54,800. we have already made an entry 54,800. So this is pertains, this pertains to the sales and closing stock 54,800. 54,800. And branch trading, this is the 44,000 is the amount which reflects for opening stock and for goods received, and this is the amount which reflects for the net profit 4,400. We can see yes, 4,400 is the being incorporation of branch expenses 4,400, and this is the general profit of rupees 6,400. This is the this 4,400. You can say that this 10,800 is the gross profit, because this was the total of the credit side of the trading account, this was the total of the debit side of trading account. So this difference is termed as gross profit. And then this fourth one is Kanpur branch profit and loss account debit to Kanpur branch 4,400 for incorporation of branch expenses. So any amount which is supposed to be written in the debit side of profit and loss account, so for that Kanpur branch profit and loss account has been debited, and accordingly any item which need to be recorded in the credit side of profit and loss account, for that reverse entry will be passed. So here there are two items which belongs to the expenses. So this is the incorporation of branch expenses, being incorporation of branch expenses 6,400. So both have been given in the trial balance 6,400 and 4,400. We can easily calculate. Yes, yes, total amount was 10,400. So this 10,400 has been categorized as 4,400 and 6,400. So total is 10,400. So Kanpur branch profit and loss account has been debited to Kanpur branch for being incorporation of branch expenses, so on and so forth. So here creditors, it is given in the question 400. This is the liability side, and here by closing stock, so closing stock is 9,200 asset, it is given in the trial balance. Furniture 4,800 given in the trial balance. Debtors 11,200 is given in the trial balance. By cash 3,600 is given in the trial balance. So the total of the asset side is 77,200. So here we need to prepare the journal entries pertaining to the stock, furniture, debtor, goods received, salary, rent and expenses. Yes, 4,400 is given, salaries, rent and expenses 4,400 is given. So this was the journal entries 4,400 it is given. So this is, I think, the repetition of the above entry. So this is the printing mistake, in fact. So this was all about this session on branch accounts 3. So I think with the help of this illustration, the students are now very clear how the accounts are maintained in the books of the independent branches. So with this, I extend my sincere thanks for bearing with me and made the sessions very meaningful. Thank you very much.